G'day guys, and today I've got something nice and dystopic for you coming out of Australia. Now you may recall a few videos ago I talked about how the Australian Federal Police raided the ABC headquarters down in Sydney, that's the Australian Broadcasting Company, the public news company of Australia, akin to the BBC and that sort of thing. The Australian Federal Police raided their headquarters to look for material relating to the Afghan files leaks, and amongst other things, the Afghan files detail the unlawful killings of civilians by Australian soldiers over in Afghanistan, and that sort of thing. And people are had lots of USBs taken off them and hard drives, and they're looking for evidence and they're trying to see, you know, who is involved, trying to nail journalists to the wall. Very terrible stuff. Australia has no freedom of the press. It is completely non-existent when judges can, as we've seen with the Cardinal Pell case, lock down stories and prevent anyone from talking about them, and when essentially journalists can just be raided for publishing the truth and trying to let citizens know what's going on. But to add to this dystopic mess, the Federal Police, a few months before this raid, attempted to get the fingerprints and palm scans of two journalists involved in these stories. Now, I'm no expert, but in my mind, if they had these fingerprints and that sort of thing, and then they go in and do the raid, and they find the USBs and stuff and the fingerprints are on them, well, that's how they get those people to go to jail. You lose your sense of plausible deniability in that, oh, look, someone anonymously dropped these to me. I don't know anything about them. You know, it makes it pretty damn clear that you were involved in these stories and the handling of classified material, which is seriously illegal in most countries. And we have the Home Affairs Minister Peter Dutton, Mr. Potato Head himself, talking about how basically taking a hardline police statist stance and saying, look, handling of classified material is illegal, I'm not going to drop the cases against these journalists, and I'm basically a fucked up dystopic authoritarian individual. And it's absolutely terrible. After these two series of raids that occurred, one on a News Corp journalist for, as I also detailed, leaking a published plan, or leaking a proposed plan to basically mass spying of Australians, mass surveillance and that sort of thing, she got raided too. So after these two raids occurred, the News Corp and the ABC, they all got together and they obviously wanted to get something done about this, because this is all kinds of fucked up. This is horrible that, you know, journalists are out there trying to bring the truth of what the Australian government is up to the populace, but that's totally illegal, and you'll be raided and have all your, you know, homes go through, and it's a blatant intimidation tactic, as I said before. But unfortunately, these journalists realized, I suppose, that the only people that could prevent the government from being terrible and dystopic like this is the government. So they had to go to the government and ask them very nicely to stop being so fucking dystopian. And what has the government done? Well, they just ignored them. And that's the terrible thing. Like, we're completely disarmed in Australia. We have no freedom of speech. We have no freedom of the press. And the only people we can ask to reverse this is the government. And they're not going to want to give up that power they have over us. They don't want us to know what's going on at all. And apparently they want to attempt to preemptively nab you for leaking classified material by getting your fingerprints. Now, it was a request, it wasn't like a mandatory thing, so obviously they sent this email off to the ABC saying, hey look, we would like the fingerprints and palm scans of these two journalists, and the ABC said, you know, what the fuck, piss off, essentially. But then they went ahead and did the raid anyway, and they're trying to throw some military defense lawyer in jail for possessing this material, and it's all kind of fucked up. So I thought I'd share that with you all. This is something that doesn't seem to be talked about by the wider community around the world. Australia does seem to exist in this weird little bubble sometimes. I guess there's a lot of other important things going on around the world, but this is absolutely terrible and dystopic. Everyone needs to know about this. Please spread the word. Thanks all for sticking around, and have a good one.